Let's talk about, if you were a DJ, you know where this side is coming from. Let's discuss the best B-side. If you started with Cuban last one, let's start out with Cypress on this one.
For which release, though?
Let's talk about the obvious elephant in the room. How I could just kill a man.
Brooklyn niggas.
The official B-side to the Funky Feel one.
The hell of a single.
Yeah, it was a monster.
Yeah. You couldn't tell me they wasn't from Brooklyn.
Man. I just see the video.
Man. I can see Tupac and his boys running around the hood enjoying.
And Monstro in the room. It's only right that we were going to talk about this monster record. The monster record. It changed, I think, the temperature and gauge of what hip hop period was kind of experiencing at that point in time. Sure. That being said, a bigger record off Death Certificate than the big one itself. Pause. No Vaseline.
Oh!
Oh, man. You can't do that.
Fuck all y'all. Goddamn, I'm glad y'all set it off. Used to be hard, now you just went soft. You was down with the AK. And now I see you on a video with Mr. Lane, looking like Strange Bones. I saw it coming, that's why I went solo. So. It caught blood stomping. Well, y'all motherfuckers knew straight out of Compton. Living with the whites, one big house, and not another nigga in sight. I started off with too much cargo, dropped four niggas, now I'm making all the dough. White man just wounded. The niggas with attitudes, who you fooling? Y'all niggas just phony. I put that on my mama and my dead homies. Yellow boys on your team, so you're losing. Hey, yo, Drake, stick to producing. Calling me on a quick, you get a dick. Easy, so you ask to win it quick. You got jealous when I got my own company. But I'm a man, and ain't nobody helping me. Trying to sound like the American most. You can yell all day, but you don't come close. Cause you know I'm the one that's broke. You done ran 100 miles, but you still got one to go. With the L-E-N-C-H-M-O-P, and y'all disgrace to CPT. Cause you get fucked at your green by a white boy. But no Vaseline.
Vicious.
I couldn't even let the scratches ride.
You know how much controversy that record was when it came out?
Yeah. No, he never had dinner with the president.
That doesn't apply anymore.
Listen, two big records going at it. Like I said, it's only right there. It's the biggest records in the room. Let's talk about How I Get His Killer Man versus No Vaseline. Who do you got?
No Vaseline.
That's speak that. On a trip.
You say for me. I don't say that shit. that No Vaseline, it went down one of the greatest pop disc records of all time. Yeah. That's up there.
Yeah, for sure.
It's definitely one of the top 10 or top 3. This is in like hip hop history for sure.
Like top sure, five. For sure.
Top five. There you go. I like that top five. Yes.
It should be number five. One. It should be number one.
It should be number one for real.
I mean, that could be a whole episode that we might have to hold on to right there. Pause. So maybe that's actually a good conversation for another time. Top five disc records. But listen, we're respectfully talking about two big records that, again, changed the scope of music at that time. I think No Vaseline could be considered one of the biggest levels at the time of taking disc records to other levels.
That shit was a big horse, man.
Right. And then you got How I Get His Killer Man, which took music to a different level that we were like, it wasn't like anything else at that time. Let's be clear. That's why I felt about Cypress. It was like, what is that? The use of guitars, just all the extra noise. Mm-hmm. Like Mastermind said, using his nose. All that stuff accumulates to, like I said, to both these kind of records standing on each other's pedestals at the moment. So take that into consideration when you're going against both. We have one vote right now from Trip for No Vaseline. Is anybody else with the same or any different?
Q was in the video too.
Cube is in the video. You're 100% right.
To kind of echo what you said, Jules, I mean, to just kill a man is it's describing like it's giving people a window into LA. Cause I mean, this course is, this is something you don't understand. And they live that every day in that moment. Like where we live, this is what it is. Cube did that as well, but
yeah, he did really well too.
It's really hard to go against No Vaseline, man. It's such a powerful song, man. And it, he left no doubt about who he was talking about.
Yeah. About them
in that moment. And quite honestly, man, like I know, you know, for the cameras or whatever, you know, him and Dre are cool. But I don't, how do you come back? How can you be friends with somebody that did that to you in the public on that level, like just aired you out?
What he did, like, this is the, I shouldn't cut you off, but I think they're cool because everything got better for Dre and the rest of the members when they actually listened to what he said and did what he said in that song.
But he torched them, man. He torched them so much that I don't know if y'all remember the scene from Straight Outta Compton, yeah. But when they were listening to it, their own friends was laughing at them over the shit he was saying.
But you know what, Hobo? You still didn't pick one.
I said I got death certificate. I mean, I said this is really hard to pick against No Vaseline. Yeah,
but you said, but you didn't.
I'm sorry. I'll use my words correctly. Please, thank you. Yeah. I pick No Vaseline.
Fair enough. So Hobo and Trip being the first ones to put their votes down for No Vaseline. I sound like this might be the trend in the room. Is nobody feeling How I Could Just Kill a Man? Does anybody want to put a vote down for How I Could Just Kill a Man at this point?
I got Cypress.
I will.
Why is this game?
Everybody made great points with the records, but I think sensibilities-wise, I think No Vaseline is going to be one of those records that you're going to appreciate in your house, and you're going to appreciate it from time to time. How I Could Just Kill a Man, wherever you're out in the public, if that record comes on, the neck is going to start to move. It doesn't matter where you're at, who's playing it. It could be a lounge outside. It could be anywhere. That record is going to get played. That record, if you want to think about it, to me, like almost like a pop status in a sense, right? Because that record is so well known it's so well played that it comes on anywhere, any given time, you're automatically going to gravitate to that. And No Vaseline is a phenomenal record. What's that?
It's about killing a man.
Yeah. Which is crazy, right?
But and cops. And cops, mind you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. One time tried to come in my home, grab my phone, and say, yo,
it's song.
Cover, son.
You know, but based off of that, No Vaseline is, I remember when that record came out and it was a lot of controversy, but I think it's a record that you have to appreciate at a given time. So my vote was for Cypress Hill.
Got it down.
I'm going to go with Cypress on this one as well, too. I think that song and that beat, because it's a switch up in the beat as well on this song. And the thing is that I like beats that kind of switch up, and the flow can switch up with the beat, and it's all on one song, so it's just not always continuous. So I'm definitely gonna go with How to Kill a Man. It's an iconic song about killing a man. Yeah.
You know what?
understanding about how to kill a man. That's all.
You know what? I'm gonna change my vote.
Oh!
What are you gonna do? What?
This is technically not over.
Oh, okay.
The round is not over.
Man, you made a great point, and I'm going to change my vote.
Wow. Vote for Scan.
I want it to be noted.
Scan in 2024.
You guys are messing up the polls, kid. The Mandarin.
I understand. This is it. This is what I'm talking about. I'm laying brothers up. I want to be clear. The gerrymandering that's going on, the hobo mandering that's going on. All of a sudden, he wants to back out of his bet and pull out and bet on the other horse. Pause. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I see you're scared. You're scared. You see the way the room is starting to vote one way. You know what I'm saying?
Is that a word?
Isn't that the point of this for us to have a discussion barbershop style? Right. And if I choose to change my mind, I could change my mind.
Absolutely can. I didn't know it was that easy to change your mind. But guys, now that you know, you know.
Is hobo mandering a word now? Is that
I'm a free thinker.
You saw how he leaned back? He leaned all the way back and said, you know what?
I know. You know what? Let me just change my vote real quick.
Yeah. You mean all the way back. Me and Malcolm Tim been texting. I mean, I've been thinking. Watch this. Malcolm
Tim is going no Vaseline.
Who do you got? What do you got, Mal?
I'm going no Vaseline. You know this.
Nice try.
I'm going no Vaseline.
He's going on. Oh, okay.
Yo, man.
I'll be giving Hobo shit later about what he just did, but you know, no, I understand it. But look, you know, I ain't gonna lie, that's the biggest thing about this matchup right here. Like, clearly, the beats and the production on Cypress Hill are superior. You know, Sir Jinx is cool, but come on, like most of the beats you heard on Death Certificate, you've heard before. You heard Daz that they used on No Vaseline. You know, you heard a lot of these, not every single beat. Some beats were really dope. You know what I mean, and different. But most of the beats was stuff that you kind of heard, and he just did in a real funky, you know, West Way or whatever. Cypress Hill was just some other stuff. So yeah. I get it on some DJ type stuff, but No Vaseline, in my opinion, is by far the best, the greatest diss song ever. Because like I said before, this, you know, not only did he torch the group, it's one dude against four dudes, you know, the hardest, roughest dudes ever.
And the manager.
Yeah, not only did he torch them, not one of them said anything back and came back at him with a diss record, and they all listened to what he said and did what he said. That's the hardest diss ever. Whoever dissed him. I'm talking about a diss record coming back.
Not a diss record, but to say none of them never said anything.
Well,
Rin said something.
Yeah. But it's going to be little stuff, but I mean, like, I'm talking about someone like, he made a diss record against all of them. None of them took the time to make a diss
record. They beat up female hosts over this shit.
Word.
You know what I'm saying? Like, wow. This shit got real.
Wow. You brought that up. Wow.
Listen, let's be clear. Dr. Dre, you still got to answer for that shit, bro. Like, that shit is not cool. Sorry. How big you are today. Like, yeah. And I hear that's a recurring theme with your ass. I'm just saying, like,
yeah,
he's not in the battle today.
But just for me, the significance of that song, as strong as it's been, like, I think that's the gold standard for a diss record. When no one comes back at you, no one makes, I mean, you know, a comment here or there is no big deal, but actually make another song to come back after you torched them that hard against those dudes who were the hardest group, the hardest, you know, group in rap at the time, supposedly, the most dangerous group. They ain't say that's nothing. True. So I'm like, that's all just ridiculous. The crossover,
I think Q was one with the attitude.
Definitely
he had a reason
to
go. He had a reason.
So hold on. I hear you agreeing. Does that mean you're gonna go back to
relax?
I'm just asking. You're so easily swayed, like something in the breeze. Like,
you gotta
all of a sudden, you're on the other side of the fence. Listen, so we have a few people left that haven't voted. We have a scan in the vote. In the vote for How I Could Just Kill a Man, Cool Breeze for How I Could Just Kill a Man, Hobo all of a sudden for How I Could Just Kill a Man, and we have Trusky, Malcontent for No Vaseline, we got the Good Reverend, and we got Mastermind left. Who do you guys got?
I like both of them.
Why can't we both?
This guy.
I'm like both of them. No. Let me cut that. No. Check this out. The No Vaseline is dope. I liked it. He had his issue with the group, torched him, right? Mm. But he don't stick with Cypress Hill. I'm sticking with that Killer Man, you know, for the fact that also they used that song for the soundtrack of Juice.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they did.
Yeah, good point.
And that was boosted. They boosted that album, you know. That was a good boost for Cypress Hill. Yeah.
That was a good look for them. That was real good.
Yeah, they cameo in it. Wasn't one of them in it?
Yeah, B-Real was in it for sure.
Yeah, B-Real was in it.
Yeah.
Tretch,
that is even the hallway, right?
I thought they were at the corner store.
B-Real and Juice?
I thought they were at the corner store.
Juice? No?
They weren't at the corner store when they were out there at that corner store, the convenient, the bodega. I thought it was out there.
Well, Rodimus?
Nah. Rodimus.
No, I remember.
You're right. Rodimus was running with Tretch and them.
They didn't have a line.
B-Real? I don't remember B-Real and Juice.
I think they were goons. I don't think they had a
line. He was in the hallway, right?
You can look it up.
I feel like he was in the hallway at the party. That's what I feel.
I thought he was at the bodega, but okay.
Wasn't it? I think, let's look it up. I mean, that might be the easiest.
It's going to be like, we know he wasn't in the movie. Like, oh.
Special Ed was in it. Everybody knows that one.
JT that. Freeze, baby.
He was playing JT Freeze.
You want to know a crazy fact I found out about Juice? The location budget for that movie had to be a pair of Tim's and a couple of sandwiches because they shot the whole movie within three blocks, yo.
Three blocks.
Yeah, the whole movie is shot on 128th and St. Nicholas between St. Nick and Convent. The entire movie.
What else do you need?
You're right.
That's New York for you, baby.
Make something with nothing. But when I looked at that, I said, wait a minute. I know that park. Wait, the deli's right there. Am I the only one that thought Blizz was Will Smith? I can't be. I was like, is Will Smith and Juice robbing in the store? Oh shit.
That's Blizz, what's up, Q?
So cute. Sorry, Rev, since you're so eager to talk about, you know, Juice, can we get your answer on this particular battle though? Who did you have when we talked about how this Killer Man versus No Vaseline? You was on mute most of this time. Now you're not muted. Who do you got?
I'm going with Cypress Hill on this one. I gotta go with what's that? Otis Redden scans? I'm going with that. Good old days when they used to layer samples.
Yes.
Yeah. Was that SP-1200 on that album? What do you think?
That's a couple of machines.
Oh, yeah, wait. For Cypress, yeah, SP-1200, because Mugs have like a chain of them. So, yeah, SP-1200.
Do you think they're using something different on the West Coast? I mean, excuse me, they're both West Coast. You think they were using something different in Cube Studio, like Jinx and Boogeyman in them?
I mean, most of that to me still sounds like if it's not SP-1200, it's going to be a Sonic Mirage based off the sound. So, I mean,
it's 91. It's also, was that available in 91?
Yeah, Mirage is the first one before the ASR 10 and all that other stuff.
When we asked the question best B-side, we decided to put the question to the test. How I Could Just Kill a Man versus No Vaseline off both projects, the Cypress Hill debut, Cypress Hill self-titled, and then Ice Cube's Death Certificate. We decided to put these records against each other, and while it wasn't, again, one-sided, it definitely was a little bit more weighted on the How I Could Just Kill a Man side of the room, giving Cypress round number 3's win, putting Cypress Hill 2-1 officially in the game.